Previously on The Bill.
You've got me.
Is she on any kind of medication?
Anything like that might lead to her losing the kids.
P.C. Johansson, I presume.
Onwards and upwards from now on.
Right, Steve, you're with Yvonne in the area car. Andrea, you're with Tony and Reg. Can you pair up with Amber, please, today?
Yeah, Sarge. It's been my pleasure.
Don't worry, Amber. Marilyn keeps him on a tight leash.
You've got anything more to add, Mum?
And someone's throwing a party?
Only the best sergeant we ever had.
I've saved my speeches for tonight, but I know you're in tomorrow. But as this is your last briefing, good luck. And we're sorry that you're going.
Thank you. Right, we've still got a job to do. Off you go.
Sarge, I need a word with you about Gabriel. Ever since that you went to the major investigation team and told them that he raped Kerry, I just feel really uneasy that he thinks it was me that dubbed him in.
Look, I promise this won't go on for much longer. But if I can get close to him, he might let something slip. He has to pay for what he did to Kerry.
Amber, how's it going?
Fine. Thanks for asking.
Oh, Joan, I need to ask you a favour. Mm-hmm. I know that Reg is an experienced officer, but I don't think he's quite the right role model, you know. Amber's a little bit tricky, so would you mind pairing up with her? Sorry.
Yeah, it's Jim Carver for Mr. Zaccardelli. If somebody's there, can you please pick up? Call me as soon as possible. Thank you. Jim, hold on a minute. I was just wondering how it was all going.
Fine.
So you sorted out your money problems?
I'm using the money that I won on the horses to pay off the plastic. Everything is under control.
Steve.
Look, don't mention that £3,000 to anyone, all right?
I've done it. I've just done my last briefing. And in 2 days' time, we're going to be sailing the world. And after that, I've got the rest of my life to enjoy. Embarrassed? If I want to kiss the man I love, I will.
Kieran, can you take your sister aside? Thanks, mate. You're too late. Maggie's gone. I'm sorry to have called you, but there's no one else.
What happened? I thought your wife had been sectioned.
The hospital decided that she wasn't as bad as we thought. She came home this morning in fine form, but as you can see, it didn't last long.
Why don't we just, go through this properly?
I shouldn't have asked that. I just wanted to know, why did she try and hurt herself? And it must have brought it all back. My fault.
Mac is ill. It's nobody's fault.
I knew she was ill, and I did nothing about it. Excuse me. The kids are terrified. I love her, but I can't do this anymore. I've got to think of the kids. Maggie's not just a danger to herself. I've got no choice. I've got to do it.
Do what, Chris?
I've spoken to a solicitor. I've decided to get an injunction keeping her away from the kids. I'm sorry to drag you into it.
What do you mean?
Well, they're going to call you as a witness.
Sarge, Margaret's at the station. She wants to see you.
I'm sorry about the window. You know, they put me on these tranquilizers. It makes it really difficult to think straight. Suppose he wants you to have me locked away again.
I think the last thing he wants is to hurt you.
So why is he trying to stop me from seeing my children?
Maggie, he's scared. He's not trying to hurt anybody, really. He's not. He's just trying to protect the children.
From me? He knows I'd never hurt them. Can't you do something? What he's doing, it's wrong.
Well, hopefully that's what this afternoon's going to be about. It's not just for Chris, it's for you. It's an opportunity for you to tell the court what you're going through.
But supposing they believe his side?
You will tell them, won't you, that I love my children?
Well, yes, it's just not as simple as that, you see, because Chris has called me to be a witness.
I don't understand.
Well, the court will want to know if I think you pose a risk to the well-being of your children.
And do you?
Excuse me, one minute, please. Yes.
It's D.I. Manson. He's put me onto another investigation. He wants me to start right away.
Didn't you tell him we were snowed under?
I tried, Sarge, okay, but with Rob missing, CID's going to be stretched. The D.I. says that he's sure you'll understand and you'll be able to prioritise.
Oh, great. Maggie, I'm really sorry. I'm completely up to my eyeballs in it. I've got to get back to work. We can talk at the court later, but it's not a good idea for you to go back home. So is there somebody that you can stay with?
There's my friend Mary, I suppose.
Oh, good. Okay.
Yeah, well, you know, you could learn from Sergeant Atkin. I mean, she does know what she's doing.
But, Reg, I want you to teach me.
I won't worry about her.
I'm not worried. I just don't like the woman. Wherever I go, the puppy follows.
Oh, it's just being friendly. You know, Steve is a nice guy.
He's a boy. I prefer a bit of experience.
Well, that's him safe. He's about as far from experience as you can get.
He isn't, is he? Are you saying he's a virgin?
Hey, hey! I ain't saying anything. Just forget it.
If that was true, you'd just have to.
Oh, no, not me. Like you say, experience wins every time.
Oh, great. Here comes Doris.
Amber, we're leaving. Let's go.
How was she?
I think she's very scared of losing her children.
Did she say where she was going to stay?
Yeah, she's staying with a friend, I think. She said, Mary. What's the matter?
Mary emigrated years ago. She's in Italy. You see, this is what it's like. I don't even know when she's telling the truth anymore.
I don't think she does either. I think it's the illness, Chris.
I know that. I don't want to get this injunction. Well, what else can I do? What choice have I got? This is killing me. I love her. You tell me this. Do you think my kids are safe when she's in this condition?
Where did you go?
Chris told me about Mary.
Do you think if we talk to him, he might change his mind?
I don't think that's a very good idea.
You're right. He can be really stubborn. God, look at me. Can't go in looking like this. You should have said.
I can just hear the judge now. She can't take care of herself. How can she take care of her children? That better?
Yeah.
You do understand that this hearing is not an attack on you. It's about what's best for the children, yes?
I think I know what's best for my own kids.
Really? Are you sure?
What do you mean by that?
Well, when you smashed up the window, did you think to see where the children were?
That was different. I was angry. I would never, ever hurt my children. You do know that, don't you?
Not deliberately, no.
And that's what you're going to tell the court?
Well, I'm going to have to be honest. I'm going to have to tell the truth.
You're just doing your job. I love my family. It is that simple. Nothing else matters.
Say what you like in court.
I'll be fine.
Please, Maggie, listen to me. Maggie! Look. Let me help. You're gonna need some money.
Maggie? I'm sorry.
Don't you apologize to me. You apologize to my children. And you tell them why they don't have a mother anymore.
Maggie, where are you going to stay? If you want somewhere temporary, I can help you.
I don't want your help.
Ugh. I know people are skint, but tidying up your garden doesn't cost anything, apart from drinking time.
When you're on duty, leave your prejudices at home.
Let go!
Oh, you just hang on!
Hey, Amber! Oh. Let go! I said let him go.
Val McGrath, that brat of yours is going to wish he'd never been born.
So will you if you touch Rocky again. Did you see what she did? He's only 9, she was assaulting him.
Rubbish.
Holding a child by the neck's a serious offence. Name, please.
This is ridiculous. He was throwing dog muck at Mrs. Hardy. She's 83. You should be arresting him, not me.
Please see your hands and just leave it in there.
I should have known it. You can't see a crime when it happens under your nose.
Madam, if your son was throwing dog muck, then that's assault. You're lucky he's too young to be arrested.
You might have everybody else in this estate running scared, but you don't frighten me.
You better watch yourself. You touch my Rocky again, I'll have you. What are we doing here, Sarge?
I want to know what she meant by the McGraths scaring people.
There you go.
Oh, great. Thanks, Mrs. Kelly.
Oh, die, please. People only call me Mrs. Kelly when I'm in trouble.
Am I in trouble now?
You assaulted a child.
That child was a McGrath. It's not the first time something like this has happened, then.
Everyone knows Val McGrath's got her kids on the rob. They strut around this estate like they own the place.
Well, are any of these robberies ever reported?
She only picks on people too weak to fight back. I'll give you a guided tour if you like. See for yourself the damage that family's caused. Somebody's got to stop him.
Yeah, well, that's our job, not yours. So no more one-woman crusades, eh?
Well, apparently Rini's on his way. Oi, the gym?
Oh, sorry.
What's with a long face?
Nothing. I better deal with this.
I'm working.
Yes, I know I called you. This is important. Around the corner. I'll be there in 5. I need 5 minutes. 10 tops.
You can't go there. What are you talking about?
Oh, really? I'm sorry I'm late.
DC Drummond, this is DC Carver.
I'll be as quick as I can.
Does your colleague realise how serious this is? I'm being blackmailed.
Yeah, well, he'll be back in a minute. So, Mr. Rini, why don't you start by explaining why you're being blackmailed and who by?
DC Jim Carver. What can I do for you today?
Here. £3,000. Count it. I won't be offended.
That's very kind of you. But your first repayment of £10,000 is not due till tomorrow.
Call it a gesture of good faith.
Faith? I'm a businessman, not a priest. The only faith I have is in these contracts. You do remember contracts?
Of course I do.
Good. Because including those £3,000, you still owe me an awful lot of money.
You will get your money back. I'm just going to need more time.
We have an agreement. And I'm like a bank. And if you break your contract, well...
You're threatening me?
No.
You know I will pay you back. I just don't know when.
You owe me £40,000 plus interest. And believe me, I will get that money. One way or the other.
Come on! Get up! Get up! Get there! Get me!
Oi! Leave him alone!
What's up? You don't want some, do ya?
Baby fast!
You all right? Did she hurt you?
She never catch her.
What are you doing here?
Fast enough, is it?
Get up!
You seem to hang around trouble, don't you?
Maybe I do.
And the world with you later. You all right?
Yeah, I will be. And you are? Vicky McGrath.
Bit of a family affair, this, isn't it? Any relation to Val?
Might be. That's mine, thief! Funny that, because I just saw you taking it off that kid. Rocky, find Mum! Now! Nicky McGrath, I'm arresting you for robbery. You do not have to say anything, but it may harm your defence if you do not mention when questioned something you later rely on in court.
This man you say is blackmailing you, Barry Devlin. How do you know him?
I used to run a pub. He was a regular.
And were friends?
I laughed at his jokes. He's not the sort of guy you want as an enemy.
How do you mean?
He's done time. Robbery, assault. There were rumours he was pimping girls.
So when you first made contact?
He just turned up at a restaurant one day for a drink and kept coming back. He said it was for the good food and the great company.
Sorry about that. Carry on.
Look, before we go any further, I want your word you won't tell my wife about this.
We'll be as discreet as possible, Mr. Rainey. What have you got there?
It's a CCTV from me. It shows me giving Devlin $5,000. He said it was a one-off payment.
I tell you, he's asking for more money.
He's turned up the other day. If I don't give him another $5,000, he said he'll show it to my wife and children. He's even threatened to burn my restaurant down.
So what's on this tape, Mr. Rainey?
Me. With a waitress. She flattered me and I fell for it. She must have been one of Devlin's girls. He's coming for his money tonight. You have to stop him.
It's just so frustrating. The Barnes family need help, but they're just not getting it because the system does not work. And I don't know how I'm meant to cope, stood up in court, when I know the rest of CSU is grinding to a halt.
If you're under-resourced, I'll deal with it. Look, I'll catch you later.
Okay.
Neil, we need to talk about the CSU. It is one of the Met's biggest priorities, and I think we could do a lot better.
I agree, Gough. Actually, I've had some thoughts on how we can improve things. Maybe we can talk them through later on.
Oh, OK. But I value the community safety unit highly, so I'm looking for actions, not platitudes.
Absolutely.
I want to see my daughter.
Sergeant Ackland's on the way. Excuse me. You're not allowed to smoke in here.
I want to see Nikki, I want to see her now.
Of course. Come straight through.
Right. Good. Come on.
No, he'll have to stay here.
This won't take long. Well, what are we waiting for?
Marilyn, can I keep an eye on you? This way, Mrs. McGraw.
Kids fight all the time, it's no big deal. Stealing a mobile phone is.
Who said I nicked it?
We saw you. And the kid you nicked it from told us that you forced him to hand it over.
He's a liar!
Shut it. Leave the talking to me.
You're not helping her.
Don't tell me how to talk to my own kids.
If Nikki tells us what happened...
You'll stitch her up. Say nothing, girl. Let them do their own dirty work.
Mrs. McGraw, if you continue like this, I will have to ask you to leave.
That kid started the fight. Nikki was defending herself.
That is not what he told us and it's not what we saw.
Well, I bet when his mum and dad gets here, he'll remember things differently. Like how he gave Nikki the phone as a present. Go on, ask him. See what he says.
Yes, I know I'm overdrawn. That's why I called. Oh, thanks for nothing. Banks, you can't live with them.
And you can't shop without them.
What do we got?
This Gov is Rainey paying Devlin. Now, he says he gave him $5,000. Now, we checked his bank statements and he said he drew the money that day.
What about the other tape?
Well, let's just say he's got exotic tastes. I can understand why Rainey didn't want his wife to watch it.
Well, she's going to find out sooner or later.
I'll run some checks, Gov. Rainey's right about Devlin's previous, but he's not exactly a saint himself.
Go on.
Well, Devlin served 2 years for robbery. He got out a couple of months ago. Rainey and Devlin were pulled together, but nothing was proven. I've spoken to the investigating officer, and it looks like they were partners. Over $30,000 was stolen. None of it was ever recovered.
So maybe Devlin's come for his share of the money, and Rainey's refused to pay.
Or can't. Maybe the money's already spent. I mean, it must have cost a few bob setting up that restaurant.
It's all guesswork. Rainey might be telling the truth about being blackmailed, but if he wants our help, he's going to have to start being straight with us.
Tell me to mind my own business if you like, Jim. But are you all right?
I don't like being lied to. Now, Rainey's not stupid. He must have known we'd run some checks.
I'm not talking about the job, Jim. I'm talking about you.
fact is, Mr. Reaney, you lied to us. We know that you and Devlin are more than casual acquaintances.
I didn't lie. I just didn't tell you. Because I knew this would happen. I knew you wouldn't believe me.
So what else haven't you told us?
Nothing. Devlin was the one convicted, and now he's blackmailing me.
If you stole his share of the proceeds of the robbery, it's not blackmail, is it?
I wasn't involved.
Then you better start being straight with us, if you want us to help you. What about the girl in the tape? If she worked here, where are her records?
She got paid cash in hand. I never had any records. It's Mandy, it's my wife.
Nice.
Look, we have to be more careful.
If this goes to court, she could find out everything anyway. You might as well tell her now.
What I tell my wife is my business.
Look, mate, it's your word against his.
What about the tapes?
We have to catch him in the act. Look, we need you to wear a hidden microphone when he comes for the money tonight.
It's the only way.
Check your belongings.
I don't understand why we're letting her go. You saw what happened.
Because the boy's parents have just phoned and they don't want to pursue it. Right, Nikki hasn't admitted to the offence, so without the victim's statement, it will never stand up in court.
Oh well, we've got better things to do than sort out stupid kids. Are we done, Sarge?
Yep, it's all yours.
If you'd like to follow me, Miss McGrath.
No joy then.
The McGraths have got quite a reputation. People on that estate are genuinely scared of them. I'd like to follow it up.
Well, that's very noble of you. But have you got anything to follow up?
Val McGrath's been done for shoplifting, handling stolen goods, but apart from that, I just know that if people on that estate felt at least some of us really cared, they might start telling us what's really going on.
Some of us?
I'm sorry. That Amber, she is impatient and she's intolerant with the public. She acts as if all this is beneath her.
But you've only been working with her for one day. Give her a chance. Do your best, June.
Mind if I join you? Unless you're trying to avoid me.
I thought it was the other way around.
No, just having a bad hair day. Sorry, I've been a complete cow.
What have I done?
Nothing, honestly. I reckon it's just a wind-up.
And what is?
Well, someone was trying to convince me that you're still a virgin. Like, I'd believe that.
Who told you?
Well, I think it's quite sexy. What next, Sarge? Princess Di's guided tour?
Great minds think alike. That's exactly what we're going to do.
June, have you got a minute?
Now's not a good time. I'm off on a job.
I need to talk.
Jim, I can't. I'm really busy.
It's important.
We'll catch up tonight. I promise.
This is Ardy, that lady that Rocky attacked. I'll show you her house. It's been robbed twice in the last few weeks.
Do you think Mrs. Hardy would talk to us off the record?
I doubt it. When they got home, they saw Nikki sneaking out the back. Terrified of the McGraths.
Yeah, but we can't do anything about the McGraths until people come forward. I mean, do you think people might feel more comfortable about speaking out if they weren't alone?
Unless they've got a meeting.
Yeah, what do you think?
I can make a few calls. Not saying anyone will come, though.
Don't these people want our help?
Put these out on the chairs, pretend you want to be here and shut up.
Mr. and Mrs. Hardy.
See? I told you you'll ring around and do the trick.
Oh, no.
Have I missed much? Sorry, couldn't get a babysitter. Unless you're offering. All right. If you think anyone else is turning up, you can think again. The people on this estate like to sort their own problems.
You might be able to scare some people, but you can't intimidate me. I know you're Nikki Burgle, the Hardys. So do the police.
So why don't they arrest her? If the police had been doing their job properly this morning, you'd be in the cells, not Nikki.
Right, that's enough.
You should be out there catching criminals, not sitting round here chatting. Maybe this is why no one will talk to you.
Has she approached the kids? Okay, stay where you are, I'm coming over.
Gov, it's
It's Margaret Barnes. She's at the house. She'd never have come to this.
Well, maybe not, but if Margaret's broken her injunction, your hands are tied.
I know. It's... Sorry, did you want me for something?
Yeah, discuss the CSU, but we can do that later.
Okay, good.
Ramani, don't give yourself a hard time. You've done all you could.
Okay, thank you.
June. I need to talk.
Jim,
not after the party. Not tomorrow. I should have told you a long time ago, but I didn't want to worry you.
What do you mean? What's up? Jim?
I'm in trouble, June. I've got debts. I have big debts.
But I gave you £3,000. That was supposed to clear the debts.
It did, but I owe money. I owe more money. I don't know how it got so bad.
Well, how bad is it? How much do you owe?
Jim?
I don't believe what you've done.
I'm sorry. I'm really sorry.
Right, how much do you owe?
£5,000 or £10,000.
Well, is it five or is it ten?
It's more like 20.
Is that it?
Yeah, there's nothing else.
And are you still gambling?
No.
Oh, at least that's something, I suppose. I can't get my head round this. We'll sort something, we always do.
Really sorry.
I've got to get on this, I just have to wait.
Chris gave me this on our first anniversary. He loved me then.
He still loves you. He's just scared.
I just want to be with my family.
I know, but the injunction's not going to last forever. And what you're doing now isn't helping anybody.
But supposing they don't want me back? I can see that they're scared of me.
Maggie, they're not scared of you, they're scared for you.
Don't patronise me. I might be mad, but I'm not stupid. I used to be able to control it. But I can't anymore. It's stronger than I am.
Maggie, please don't do this. Your children need you.
Oh, they need somebody who can put them first. They'd be better off without me.
If you hurt yourself, they're going to feel absolutely awful. You don't want that for them, do you?
I just don't know what to do anymore. I can't stand it!
Maggie, you said you wanted to put your children first. Well, now's the time to do it. You're not going about it the right way, and you know it. You have to be strong. For Chris, for your children, for yourself. Now, please... Please.
What are you doing, Jim?
Oh, golf. Yeah, I was just on my way to find you.
What's the plan?
Well, Rini's denied being involved in the robbery. But there's definitely something going on between them.
Well, I want to know more about Devlin before we go out with this operation, so do some digging, see who he mixed with in prison. Is Rini prepared to let you take this conversation with Devlin?
Well, he doesn't like the idea, but yeah, I think he'll do it.
We play this right, we can nick them both. Devlin for blackmail, Rini for robbery.
Let's go.
What will the doctors do to me?
What do you want them to do?
I can't fight it anymore.
Well, you don't have to. That's what the doctors are there for.
They discharge me.
Maggie, you tell them what you told me. Don't wait for them to force you back into hospital.
You mean go back voluntarily?
Yes. Your family need you. They want you back. But you must get better.
Right.
I thought he wasn't your type.
Oh, he is now. Well, that innocent flair taking to be taught. Hey, I don't suppose you fancy a swap. You all seem to be ex-virgin from my senile Sarge.
If you've been here longer than 2 minutes, you'd know June Ackland's a good copper.
She'd rather talk to a bunch of whingers than actually tackle any criminals.
If you've got something to say about me, say it to my face. And don't think that life is going to get easier when I've gone, because it won't. You better start treading very carefully if you want to keep this job. Is there a problem? No, ma'am, not at all. Go on, off you go. I'll join you in a minute. Mum, I think some of the residents on that estate might start talking to me about the McGraths, but I need to talk to them on my own. She has got completely the wrong attitude.
I know, but like it or not, she's part of the team. And if you can't make a difference to her, I don't know who can. And another thing, June, when you're on that estate, do not make any promises that we can't keep, all right?
You all right?
Yes. It's been one of those days, Tony.
After what happened at the community centre, do you really think anyone's going to want to talk to us?
Why exactly did you join the police service?
Well, to help people, to make a difference.
It's a nice line, if you really mean it.
Wells Avenue. Female being attacked now.
It's near Dad Kelly's place.
Mr. James.
Excuse me!
It was Nicky McGraw.
All right, don't speak.
Get her. Promise me you'll get her.
Don't worry, we will. Don't just stand there. Go and wait for the ambulance.
I was walking up the stairs when I realised Nicky was standing at the top.
Why didn't you just run away?
I tried to get past. She said orders was orders and I needed to be taught a lesson.
And that's when she pushed you?
I tried to grab onto her arm to stop from falling, but she threw me over. I could hear her laughing. She was enjoying herself.
48 from 171.
Yep, received.
I've completed a search of the McGrath's house and found suspect's clothing, also recovered some stolen property, over.
Great, thanks, Reg.
They got the hardest things.
Well, it's possible. I'll have to check for fingerprints and then the hardest will have to identify their property, but thanks for your help.
Oi. Listen and learn. You might turn out to be an half-decent copper.
No, that's great. Thanks for your help. Cheers, mate.
Anything?
Well, I knew something wasn't right. It appears that Reenie's wife visited Devlin while he was in prison.
Maybe Reenie sent her.
Well, every week. I think we should speak to Mr. Reenie about his wife's social calls.
Look, you've seen the tapes. Just give me the wire and we'll catch him.
How well does your wife know Devlin?
He's here. Devlin's here.
Reenie. Good to see you.
Barry, how are you?
Never better, mate. Never better. And I suppose you know what Reenie's up to. You are old Bill, aren't you?
His wife told you we were here, didn't she?
Mandy called me up when she realised you lot were sniffing around Reenie. I knew he was up to something. But framing me for blackmail? I'm impressed.
We know that you two were involved in a robbery and the money was never recovered. So what happened? Did Reenie spend your share?
He ain't got the bottle to steal off me. He must have found out about me and Mandy.
Well, you're saying he set this whole thing up because you were having an affair with his wife?
I guess he thought setting me up would save his marriage.
But Mandy visited you every week in prison.
Me and Mandy have been on and off for years.
We've got footage of Reenie giving you money.
I was skint. He offered to lend me some dosh. He's crafty, I'll give him that.
There's still the matter of the assault.
Oh, he deserved a slap. What he's done is worse than grassing and I ain't letting it go.
What do you mean?
The robbery. Reenie set the whole thing up.
And you'll give evidence in court?
After what he's done, he's got it coming.
It's her word against mine. Didn't you check with my mum? I've got an alibi.
You were seen walking towards Wells Avenue shortly before Diana Kelly was attacked.
Witnesses? They wouldn't what? Wouldn't dare? Not
after what you did to Mrs. Kelly, they're more than ready to talk.
Grievous bodily harm with intent can result in a life sentence. You've got scratches on your arm. If Mrs. Kelly caused those by grabbing you when she fell, then your DNA will be under her fingernails. All we have to do is wait for forensics to report back.
What will they do to me?
You told Mrs. Kelly that you were simply following orders. Whose orders were they?
We know your mum's behind this, so why cover for her? It's not like she'd do the same for you, is it?
Well, I go down.
Between attempting to pervert the course of justice and Devlin's evidence about your part in the robbery, I think you can count on it.
All I wanted was to save me marriage. What's so wrong with that? I'm going to lose everything. Do you know what that feels like?
Handling stolen goods. Like you're ever going to make that stick.
You found Mrs. Hardy's jewellery in your bedroom. I'd say that was a stone.
Rocky nicked it. How was I supposed to know? I can't watch him 24/7, can I?
Obviously not.
Poor little Rocky. He's such a worry.
It's Nikki you want to worry about.
She's a survivor. I made sure of that.
Honestly, everything those kids do is down to the mother. The chances are she'll walk and Nikki will carry the can.
I don't feel too sorry for her.
If I am, probably is time I left.
You look exhausted.
Well, it's been an eventful day.
Dealing with people like Margaret Barnes isn't easy. You convinced her to readmit herself to hospital, you've proven once again how vital CSU is.
It's thanks to you that the department's working so well.
But for how long? I mean, it's, we don't have the bodies to sustain this.
Well, you should have. CSU needs to grow. Which is why we're proposing the creation of a vulnerable persons unit.
One department covering CSU, missing persons, public protection team, getting on board the Sapphire unit so we can deal with rape cases to the best of our ability. What do you think?
We're talking about working with sex offenders, probation officers, convicted rapists, rape victims. I mean, it's absolutely massive.
Right. Well, all we need to do now is make it happen. Thanks, Neil.
Go. Excuse me.
This is good news. I thought you'd be happy.
I am, in principle.
Look, don't worry. This isn't just a way for CID to get rid of its messy cases. Whatever anybody else's agenda is, I shall personally make sure that this is done properly.
When my pension starts coming through, I'm going to ask for some of the money to be paid up front. That way, we can pay the debt off all in one go.
No way. It's too much.
I'm not offering, Jim. I'm telling.
I don't know what to say.
Say yes. You haven't got any choice and you know it.
Champagne, please. All right.
Oh, you got no chance, Grandad.
She might like the older man.
I doubt it, mate.
You okay?
Yes, I hate these dudes. Everybody pretending to be best friends.
Maybe they're not pretending. Some people actually have friends. Here. That's if you still want to come in tonight. Just let yourself in, and I'll come home in a bit. This looks fantastic, you know?
That's so nice. Look what you're doing for me. How can I ever thank you?
This isn't the time or the place.
June.
Reg, I really need a stiff drink.
Oh, June, well, it is your night, isn't it? So have whatever you want.
Ready for your big moment?
Come on.
Sorry, Reg, come on.
No, that's all your fault. What is? What if you hadn't made her so happy? There's no way June would have retired.
Hello, everyone. Come on, let's have a little bit of hush, please. Come on, a little bit of hush. Thank you. Right, now, I think it's fair to say that me and you have not always seen eye to eye.
I first met June when she was working for the Community Safety Unit. And I used to call her Auntie June. June, I was wrong. Wrong about you as a person, and wrong about you as a sergeant. Now, June has been at Sunhill for, 21 years. And we will all really miss her. Not just us. Whether they know it or not, Joe Public are losing a very special copper. Yeah. And she's doing all this because she wants to go off and enjoy herself and get a life. Please, is that allowed? Anyway, you've earned it. And I know that you and Jim are going to be very happy for a long, long time. So let's hear it, everybody. June Ackland!
What are you doing out here?
Well, I'm fine. I hardly know June, and she doesn't really like me anyway.
No way, what's there not to
like? Thank you for everything.
Oh. Thanks, Steve.
There are people here who I would trust with my life. People who never have and never would let me down. And I shan't forget that. I shall miss you all.
Stand there. You know she's having a fuss made of her. Go help her out.
Ah, Smithy, perfect timing. How did you know it was your turn?
Oh, I take it you're not after my body.
Exactly. And ask Jim, please.
Mm, absolutely. Yeah, mate. Are you sure this is what you want?
What I want. Do you? Ooh, don't let me interrupt. Flying lessons?
Well, you know, I thought you could do some excitement in your life.
Flying lessons and a romantic cruise with a man you love. You've got it all worked, haven't you?
I'm really going to miss you, you know.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Oi, steady, Gov.
Yeah, I think we're going to go and sit down, Jack. Go on, over there, that
way. Let's get a drink.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
You're avoiding me.
Because I'm angry with you and I need some space.
Talk about money on the evening of your party, but...
You don't get it, do you? This isn't about the money. It's about you and me. I trusted you, but nothing has changed. You just traded one addiction for another.
Look, I know you must be angry, but we're going away. We can work things out together.
No, I'm going on that cruise on my own. I need time to think, and I don't want you anywhere near me. Now just leave me alone.
June!
Did you hear me? Leave me alone! I don't even know if I want to see you again!
Next time on The Bill.
Easy!
I owe money.
How much?
£37,000.
He's a drug dealer. He came to my house. He trashed my house.
Maybe next time you should try engaging your brain before you open your mouth.